Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install PyCharm IDE in your industrial operating system. So let's begin. Now before installing PyCharm IDE, let us first understand what this PyCharm IDE basically is. PyCharm IDE is basically an IDE using which you can do Python related project. So if you are doing some big project in Python, it is always recommended to use some IDE. And PyCharm is basically one of the best IDE for Python related project. Now to install PyCharm IDE, you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in here just simply type PyCharm download. Then enter, and then you'll be seeing our first search result is from www.jetbrains.com. So JetBrains is basically the company which basically developed this PyCharm IDE. To download, just simply click on this link. This will automatically going to open this official website of this PyCharm. So just simply cancel these cookies and all. And here, if you just slightly scroll down a bit, you can clearly see that there is basically these two options to download PyCharm. So for one is this professional one and another is this community one. If you are a student, then it is always recommended to download this community one because it's free. If you are doing some professional work, then it is also recommended to use this professional one. It is a paid one, but you'll get this 30 days free trial. So installing the professional one, then just simply click on this download button. But otherwise, what we are going to do in this video is we are going to download this community one. So for that, just simply click on this download. This will automatically going to download your PyCharm IDE. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just go to my download directory, you can clearly see this PyCharm community 2021.1 version has been rightly downloaded over here, and it's just 363 MB file. To install, just simply double click on it, and then just simply minimize my download directory, and here you can clearly see this PyCharm community edition setup wizard has been rightly opened. To install, first simply click on next. And this is going to be your location where this PyCharm is going to be installed. If you want to change your installation destination, then you need to just simply click on browse and you can do that. And also one more thing, you need to have at least 932.1 MB of free disk space in your C directory, since we are basically installing inside the C directory. And I have currently available 60 GB of free space, so that's not a problem. So you need to have at least 932 MB of free disk space. So I have that, and so just simply click on next. And now you'll be seeing this installation options. So in here, they basically saying that whether we like to create a desktop shortcut. So for which I just simply going to check that, and then I'm just also going to add this open folder as a project. And here they basically asking whether we like to open all py files with this PyCharm IDE. So for that, I don't want to check that, because if you are doing some other machine learning project or some other stuff related to Python, then it's not recommended to use, especially if you are doing machine learning project in PyCharm. You can do that, but it's not recommended. For that, I have already made a video on how to install this Anaconda. So use Anaconda for machine learning related project. So for that, I will not going to check this py. And this is very important, guys. You need to add this launchers directory to the path. This is very important, and you need also restart. I will show you that. You don't need to worry about that right now. So just simply check this. This is very important, and then just simply click on next. And this is going to be our folder, this JetBrains, where this installation is going to be happen. So simply keep this all default, then just simply click on install for installation. This will automatically going to start your installation. If you just simply click on the show folder, you can clearly see that how the installation is actually happening. It will take some time, maybe a minute or two. So for which I'll be coming back once when it gets done. Yeah. So welcome back. And now, as you can see, our PyCharm Community Edition setup has been rightly installed, and it's, you know, currently stating that completing this PyCharm communication setup. So as I have mentioned earlier, you need to reboot your system. So for that, what I'll be doing is, you know, just simply click on this reboot now, and then just, you know, simply click on finish. So this will, you know, going to be restarting our system. So what I'll be doing is, you know, I'll be again coming back after restarting my machine. So welcome back. And now, as you can see, our PyCharm Community Edition 2021.1 has been, you know, rightly installed, and our desktop shortcut has also been created. To fire up our PyCharm IDE, just, you know, simply double click on it. And now it's asking whether we'd like to import PyCharm settings. So if you are installing PyCharm for the first time, then, you know, just simply click on this do not import settings. But if you have installed PyCharm earlier, then you need to just simply click on this configure installation directory. I am installing PyCharm for the first time, so, you know, just simply click on this do not import settings, and then just, you know, simply click on OK. So this will, you know, automatically going to launch this PyCharm IDE 2021.1 community edition. They have created this nice logo. And now, as you can see, our PyCharm IDE has been, you know, rightly open, and it's now currently telling that welcome to PyCharm. So just, you know, simply maximize it. And in here, you can create a new project. So for that, you need to just simply click on this new project. And this will, you know, automatically going to open this new project window. And here, let's give a project name as Python app. And then in this base interpreter, you'll be seeing this python.exe. I have already installed Python, so, you know, it's currently showing that. But if you haven't installed Python, then you don't need to worry about that. PyCharm will itself download the latest version of Python. So, you know, after writing your project name, just, you know, simply click on create. And this will, you know, going to create your project. So it's now currently showing this t.d, so for which, you know, just simply cancel it. And here you can clearly see that it's now currently creating a virtual environment at the back end. So for that, it's, you know, currently downloading some packages and all. So you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation. So it's now currently, you know, downloading some package at the back end. It will take some time. And now, as you can see, our project has been, you know, rightly created. And just they're showing some Windows Defender warning, so just, you know, simply cancel that. It's not a big issue right now. So here, if you just simply click on this run button, you can clearly see this hi PyCharm has been, you know, rightly shown. So the hi is coming from here, and this PyCharm is basically, you know, coming from this main method. If you just, you know, change this to, let's say, Geeky Script, and then just, you know, simply click on this run button, and then just, you know, simply click on this run button, it will, you know, automatically going to show you this hi Geeky Script. So if you see this output coming in your console, then you just know that your PyCharm IDE has been, you know, installed properly in your machine. You can easily, you know, simply control A and then just delete, and you can easily delete everything, and then you can write your own Python code snippet over here. So if you want to just, you know, simply going to print hello world in our console, then just, you know, simply first clear everything, and then just, you know, simply type print hello world, and then if you just simply click on this run button, you can clearly see this hello world is in our console. So in this way, you can install PyCharm IDE in Windows 10 operating system. I have this website called geekyscape.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check our website geekyscape.com. So that's all for this video, friends. I have rightly shown you how to install PyCharm IDE in Windows 10 operating system, and I have also shown you how to create a new project. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.